afternoon, students. This is our third video on chapter number 1, that is reproduction in lower and higher plant. So in this video, our first topic is case of anther, and the second topic is development of male gamete before pollination and after pollination. First, we are moving towards case of anther. So mature anther having 4 walls. Actually, you have to write this answer in 2 parts. First is walls of the anther, and the second one is structure of pollen grain. So first is mature anther or the walls of the anther. Mature anther having 4 walls, epidermis, endothelium, middle layer, tapetum. But we need diagram to explain this 4 walls of the anther. So with help of diagram, I'll explain you what are the structure and function of these 4 different layers in the structure of anther.
Okay, so this is our diagram for TS of anther. Okay, what is the meaning of TS? Transverse section. Transverse section of anther. As I told you earlier, that mature anther having 4 walls or 4 layers, you can say, that is epidermis, endothelium, middle layer and tapetum. So now I'll explain to you one by one what is the function and nature or structure of this layer. So this is first layer, epidermis. Flattened cells are arranged compactly with each other. Okay, and they are forming the outermost layer, that is called as epidermis. So this epidermis is mostly protective in function. Always remember, whenever the outermost layer is there, the main function of the outermost layer is protection. Now the second layer, that is endothelium. Endothelium is inner to the epidermis. These cells, this somehow polygonal cell, single layer, are nothing but the endothelium. They are common for pollen sac, which are single layer. These are fibrous cells, and why they are fibrous? Because of collagen. Collagen is present in that, and because of that, they are little bit fibrous. They are situated in shallow groove between 2 microsporangia and remain thin wall. Okay, so they are situated here in between somehow. These are pollen grains, these 2 rounded shape. Here it is again 2. So these are pollen grains. So they are situated in the shallow groove of this microsporangium, and these cells are thin wall. They represent line of dehiscence. As it is hygroscopic in nature at the time of maturity. What is meant by dehiscence? In second diagram, the process of dehisced anther is given. The region of dehiscence, it means the pollen grains here. These are 2. It means the 4 pollen grains are here. Microsporangia are here. And these microsporangia at the time of dehiscence fuse with each other, and all the pollen grains are coming out from them. So here, this is line of dehiscence. It means this endothelium forming line of dehiscence, and at the maturity, this line is get breaks. As it is hygroscopic in nature. What is the meaning of hygroscopic? Hygroscopic, it absorbs more and more water as these cells are thin wall. And because they are thin wall and hygroscopic, it gets breaks easily. And that time when these microsporangia fuse with each other, all these pollen grains are coming out. So this is the function of the second layer, that is endothelium. Now the third layer, that is middle layer. Middle layer, it is internal to the endothelium. Okay? It may be 1, 2, or 3 layers. That's why with the help of arrow here, 3 layers shown in the diagram. That is, middle layer may be a single layer, or it is made up of 2 layers, or it is made up of group of 3 layers togetherly. They are surrounded to the pollen sacs. Okay, this layer is degenerated at the maturity. That is, after formation of microspore, 2 pollen sac fuse with or merge with each other in one chamber. It means here in this diagram, at the maturity, here the pollen sacs are fusing with each other. So at that time, these middle layers are going to be break or degenerated. That's why they are so thin walled, so much hygroscopy, so that at during maturation phase, they can fuse with each other. They are helping, they are degenerating themselves and helping for pollen sacs to fuse with or merge with each other. So this is the function of middle layer. And the last layer is tapetum. Tapetum is this triangular layer, which is arranged in rounded shape to these pollen grains. Okay, these cells are larger in size contain dense cytoplasm. There are diploid nucleus is present. These points, okay, you can able to see this nucleus. So nucleus is present inside the cell. As I told you that outermost layer is always protective in function, while this innermost layer is always providing nutrition to this innermost part, that is sporogenous tissues, or you can say the pollen grain. The nutrition is provided by this tapetum. It also, again, one more function is there, that this tapetum cells are able to produce sporulin. This sporulin is a component of exine. Exine is nothing but outermost layer of the pollen grain. So this sporulin is the protein which is produced by the tapetum for what? It is the outermost layer of the pollen grain. You can see, so tapetum produces sporulin, and that sporulin is useful for pollen grains to form its outermost layer, and the outermost layer is called as exine. So this is all about the four layers of anther: epidermis, endothecium, middle layer, and tapetum. So what is the next point in TS of anther? That is microsporangium, or all about this pollen sac. In short, I have explained this here. We'll focus this point only, that after this, it means the anther, the two pollen sacs are getting merged with each other during maturation. Then the immature diploid sporogenous tissues are undergoing mitosis. What is mitosis? Equational division. And the single cell forming microspore mother cell, which is again diploid in nature. And now this microspore mother cell having capacity to produce microspore by the process meiosis. Meiosis is reductional division. There is difference between mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis is equational division, while meiosis is reductional division. And when the microspore mother cell undergoes meiosis, that process is called as microsporogenesis, because in this process we are getting microspore which are haploid in nature. Single mother cell provide 4 haploid cell, that's why they are called as tetrahedral tetrads. Okay, so this is all about TS of anther. Whenever the question arises, well, explain with the help of diagram what is TS of anther. You have to explain the 4 layer, and epidermis, endothecium, middle layer, and tapetum in the TS of anther whenever you are writing that answer. And again, what is, how microspores are produced. So you can memorize that point with the help of this small flowchart. Okay, so our next topic is structure of pollen grain or microspore. Pollen grains are uninucleated unicellular cell, okay, which having dense cytoplasm and protected by 2 layers. These layers are called as sporoderm, innermost layer and outermost layer. These are haploid cell. Single nucleus is present, uninucleated unicellular single cell is present. Then cytoplasm is present, it is surrounded by 2 sporoderm. The outermost layer of this pollen grain is called as exine, which is resistive in nature, as well as in some plants this exine is spiny, and in some plants this exine is smooth. Whenever pollination is done with the help of insect, in those particular plants their pollen grain having spiny exine. And the plants which are performing their pollination, or pollination is done with the help of wind, in those plants there is not necessary that necessity that this exine should be spiny. So that seeds having smooth exine, while others having spiny exine. This exine is mainly composed of sporulin. As I have explained you in the structure of TS, the tapetum, which is the 4th layer of the anther, which provide this sporulin, and this provide this sporulin provide resistance to the pollen grain from physical and biological barriers. For example, in summer season the temperature is more, in rainy season when heavy rainfall is there, at that condition if this exine is not resistive, then it get breaks easily and the nucleus gets outside. And if the nucleus is not present inside the cell, then there is no use of that particular seed. That's why this exine should be resistant, and this resistive capacity is provided with the help of this sporulin. This is all about exine. The innermost layer is called as intine, which is smooth and which togetherly bound all the cytoplasm and nucleus inside the cell. The pollen grain having pore, and that pore are called as germ pore. In monocots, single pore is present, while in dicots, the pollen grain is triporate, that is three pores are there. The innermost layer, intine, is always attached to the germ pore. So this is all about structure of pollen grain. Then how these pollen grains are going to be developed? The development of pollen grain occur in two stages, before pollination and after pollination. So first we'll see before pollination in pollen sac, how this male, with the help of this two diagram, I'll explain you how pollen grains are developed before pollination. So first, this part is called as protoplast of the pollen grain, which divide with the help of mitosis. And this single cell is divided into two unequal cells. The larger cell is called as vegetative cell, while the smaller cell is called as generative cell. This generative cell don't have cell wall. But this vegetative cell having the cell wall. So this is the first stage of the development of male gametophyte, that is before pollination in pollen sac. This protoplast undergoes mitosis, and with the help of this process, that is mitosis, the single cell is divided into two unequal cells. The larger cell is called as vegetative cell, while the smaller cell is called as generative cell. After pollination, the pollination is done with the help of wind or with the help of insect, and these pollen grains are going to stick onto the stigma. Stigma is producing sticky substance, and that sticky substance or sticky chemical is helpful for attraction of pollen grain, or this pollen grain remain onto the stigma. For that purpose, that stigma provides this sticky substance. So because of that, as this part of that is germ pore of the pollen grain is going to stick onto the stigma, and with the help of this pore, the innermost layer, that is intine, is going to absorb all the stigmatic secretion. And as it absorbs all the stigmatic secretion, this vegetative cell, this yellow part, this vegetative cell increase in volume because its cytoplasm get increased, and as it get increase in volume, it creates pressure on this particular wall, and because of that this pollen tube is formed. The intine form the pollen tube like structure because of the pressure of volume of the cytoplasm inside the vegetative cell. This pollen tube is followed by this tube nucleus. And as here, as I told you that the stigmatic secretion is remain inside the vegetative cell, it again creates pressure on this generative cell. And now this generative cell is going to divide by mitosis into cell. This way. Into the two cell. And in this way, two non-motile haploid male gametes are formed inside this pollen tube, the large structure that is pollen tube, and tube nucleus is present, remain attached at the bottom of this tube nucleus. So in this way, the male gamete is developed inside the pollen grain. So I will repeat in short that pollen grain having the exine and intine, with the help of this germ pore, the pollen tube are formed. But before the pollination, this protoplasm is get divided into two unequal cell, that is vegetative cell and generative cell. This vegetative cell is responsible for the next development, that is after pollination, when this pollen grain is stick onto the stigma. This with the help of the germ pore, all the stigmatic secretion is get inside this vegetative cell, and vegetative cells create pressure on the innermost wall, that is intine. And because of that pressure, the intine form the tube-like structure. That tube-like structure is called as pollen tube, and the nucleus come inside this pollen tube. As that stigmatic secretion creates pressure on that this generative cell as well. And because of that pressure, inside the pollen tube, the generative cell divide mitotically into the two male gametes. And in this way, two male gametes are formed with the help of this pollen grain. And these male gametes are then further used for the fertilization purpose. Okay, so this is all about development of male gamete, that is microspore. So in this video we have completed, we have seen two topics, that is TSO of anther and development of male gametophyte. Okay, thank you.